Hi, my name is Don Sackett. I'm the CEO and co-founder of SciAps, and I'm here with my product manager, Morgan Jennings. Today, we're here to talk about our analyzers for this whole green economy electric vehicle market. And we have two analyzers that have been really popular to serve that market. The first one is our LIBS unit, set up to measure lithium in rocks and actually even brines as well, which we'll talk about later. And the second analyzer is a state-of-the-art XRF. It's our model X555. And what's unique about it, it's the only handheld that uses a 55 kilovolt tube. Why do you want a 55 kilovolt tube? Well, you need that voltage to measure the rare earth elements, the light rare earths especially, at detection limits that are commercially, you know, meaningful out there for mining and refining. Anyway, so that's what we're here to talk about today. So Morgan, you take it away with the LIBS unit.
This is our Z903 set up for geochem analysis. Right now I've got a lithium rocks calibration on here, so give you a quick test of shooting a pressed pellet like this. First, you start with a powder that's nice and homogeneous.
Right.
So every time you shoot it, you're shooting the same material. Mm-hmm. And secondly, the pellet gives you a nice hard surface for the laser to interact with. So it's a little different than XRF, where we could shoot loose powders. And
is it a pain in the neck to do that, or I mean, is it?
Not too bad. You get a press, you can get manual or automatic presses. You kind of fill a little cup, press it down with a bunch of force.
All right, press it down, takes a couple minutes.
Yeah.
And you're good to go.
Yep. All right. Yeah, and then LIBS is a contact measurement like this, so you want to hold the sample up.
Fire
away. Pull the trigger. Get a quick result here. Only takes a few seconds, and we've got lithium and many other elements can be analyzed all at the same time with this technique.
Key one being lithium. Why is that? Because you cannot measure lithium with a portable XRF device. The lithium is too low atomic number. The X-rays are way too light to be measured with this kind of a device. All right, that was neat. And so you press a pellet for a few seconds, take the shot, and even though you have to press, it's still a lot faster and immediate than sending that to a laboratory for digestion and ICP analysis.
If you really can't deal with the time it takes to press a sample, we have lots of customers who are just shooting, you know,
rock
faces or cores. You know, it's not quite as analytical as a technique that way, but you still get good results instantaneously. You don't have to wait on a lab for
if
it.
If you did that, you could be like, is it little low lithium or is it high, percent lithium, 10%, 1%, 1,000 ppm? That's like a quick, like almost screening. All right.
Yep.
We'll actually show something later, which is our brines capability. The other source of lithium out there are these brines, these basically salt lakes with lithium, right? So we use this device, but then what do we do with that to make it analyze the brine?
Yeah, it's pretty simple. So you just, we need to remove this wear plate, this front piece of metal here, two screws, replace it with a liquid plate, and then you drop it in the liquidator, which is like a benchtop test station.
Like a docking station?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Okay.
It's only about 10, 15 pounds. You can set it up on the back of a pickup truck or in a lab. Operate that through a computer, and a couple minute transition time, you get ready to take tests, specifically lithium brines.
And this is the only LIBS device that can analyze liquids. That's really quite an accomplishment that you guys have come up with to be able to do. For the brines, the same story. Right now, they get a sample of liquid. These are usually in remote places, so it's not like there's a ICP next door. So you get a sample of the liquid, you send it to a lab, you wait several weeks, get a result. With this in the liquidator, now you can get that result in a few seconds or minutes right on site. And that's lithium, obviously a hugely important element for the electric vehicle market and the whole decarbonization effort over the next 20 or 30 years. The flip side of that, you need lithium for the batteries in these vehicles, but you need rare earth metals for the magnets in these vehicles. Finding enough rare earth metals is another challenge in terms of meeting the supply and the demand for all these electric vehicles. So for that, we came up with this new model, the X555. As I mentioned earlier, it's got a 55 kilovolt tube in it. So that higher voltage allows you to measure these rare earth metals at low enough concentrations. So because it's a higher voltage tube, we always recommend that people use it in our little portable test stand, which you can see here. So you can use a baggie of sample. We just happen to have it already in a cup, but you put the sample over the window, put the lid on. It's got a leaded glass window so you can see the sample if you want. Hit the start button. We set this up for a pretty quick test because there's higher levels of rare earths here, about a 10 second test. So we'll wait till that's finished. You can hook it up to a little PC so you see your results right away. And then if you look at the result, on this particular sample, there's about percent level cerium and lanthanum, but you've got about 3,000 ppm of neodymium, some praseodymium, some samarium, and then that's pretty much all the rare earths. A little bit of cesium, no detected europium or gadolinium in that particular sample. But that's what it measures. It measures that suite of what's called light rare earth elements, which are very critical for the magnets in all these electric vehicles. These things seem to be going out the door pretty quickly as well.
Yeah,
congratulations
for sure.
On that one. All the crazy ideas we have up in the sales office, yeah. And you make them into products.
Sometimes they work, yeah.
Yeah, that's right. That's what our customers say too.
Yeah.